World of Monkeys.
Yes. When's the helicopter coming?
The helicopter will be here at 4:30 sharp. Okay. We've got time for a few more.
Okay.
Are you ready for a few more, folks? Yeah. We've had lots of requests, but I'm going to sing anyway. You know what? I feel like some rock is... You're ready for some more rock, aren't you?
Yes.
I know. I know.
Always.
And rock we shall. This is a song I wrote for a wonderful group out of the Los Angeles area. We lost this wonderful guitar player a couple of years ago. Wonderful guy. You know him and love him as I do. Mr. Eddie Van Heflin.
Abby's kid. Yes.
Nice.
Yes.
This kid had no career. Nothing was going on. He comes to me, says, Mr. Love, I want to get into this business. You are so big part of the business, show business thing. I said, what do you do, kid? He said, well, I just started playing guitar. He was horrible. He couldn't barely pick it up.
Yeah.
I sat him down, worked with him. The next thing I know, he's a virtuoso.
Yes. He got good fast.
He got good real fast, let me tell you. And then he puts the group together, Van Heflin, or Van Buren. Van Buren, wonderful group. Begging me for a hit song. So I wrote this one for him. We'd love to do it for you kids today, especially the two youngsters in the back. Sorry about that little thing with your girlfriend. Okay, here we go. Ready? Power chord. Power chord. Give me the power chord. Here we go. Let's rock for these kids. Come on, let's do it. Rock and roll, baby.
Wrong tone.
Yeah, rock and roll. Yes. Here we go. We're rocking. Let's do it. Come on. I really didn't want to bring this up today, but my nephew, Buddy Jr., is in a Las Vegas hospital right now fighting for his life. This morning, before we brought him in, for the transfusion, he looked up from his bowl of Cheerios and said,
Uncle Buddy, today, when you do that show in Coal Valley, I hope, no, I pray, that everyone jumps with you when you do jump.
Folks, I wouldn't ask you to jump for me. No. But if you could find it in your hearts and souls to jump for a little kid who's fighting for his life in a Las Vegas hospital right now. What do you say? Can we try it?
Yeah.
Here we go. Ka-chow, chow, chow. Let's jump. Let's jump for little buddy. He'll be dead in about 5 minutes. Here we go. Let's jump. It will make you feel good in your hearts. You all must try. Let's jump. Got him in the palm of our hands, and the pit boss wants him in the casino gambling. Bucks, you know what? Let the pit boss hang himself. We're going overtime for this crowd. So funny, you know. few years back, I think it was 64, I got a call in my dressing room from Sammy Davis Jr. He said, Mr. Love, I'm 12 years old. This is the kind of respect. 12 years old, calling me Mr. Love. Mr. Love, there's a new cat in town that needs your help, man. I said, Sam, bring him over. Brings in this nice-looking young man, baggy pants. He had a shirt, kind of horrible-looking shirt, button to the top, button glasses. I said, what's your name, kid? He goes, Tom Smith. Tom Smith? How the hell's going to go see a guy named Tom Smith and pay another 50 to the maitre d' to get a good seat? No one! That's why I changed his name to Tom Jones.
Of course.
Had a nice ring to it. And I had to work with him a little bit. Got him the tight pants. We got him a big puffy shirt, opened it up, got him a nice medallion, showed him a few moves. Chicks loved it. But yeah.
He did.
Well, he had a problem.
He did.
With the cucumber.
It was a little cucumber. So,
and you know what?
But it did improve dramatically when we got him to take it from the back and put it in the front.
Yes. It changed everything.
It changed the whole show. It really did. So with that in mind, here are the songs I wrote for my dear friend, Mr. Tom Jones.
That's
not it, Mr. Love. That's not the beat. That is not the beat. Give me that again. That was kind of a beat off, wasn't it? It's not unusual to be loved by anyone. Green grass. Oh.